YTDan Duel Links is sponsored by viewers like you. Support the channel directly by becoming a member.
What's going on, my boys? YTDan back at it again with another video. This week, I'm going to be covering nothing but KC Cup coverage. I want to get you guys ready and prepared for the KC Cup. I'm going to be competing as much as I possibly can. Doesn't really know exactly how much that is or how much that's going to be, but I do plan on competing as much as I possibly can in the KC Cup this week. And also, I'm going to be getting in there with some new secret spicy techniques that I have yet to reveal, my boy, because, you know, it's ultra competitive and I'm training in secret under many aliases, my boy. So you might catch me out here if you've seen one of my aliases out here. I have many, many aliases, but you'll probably see one while you're watching the replays from this video. So look, my boys. I have been getting in there recently with the number 32 Shark Drake. I really like this card. I wanted to see if there's any real competitive viability with this card. And I would say, man, the crazy thing about this is, yes, there is. There is a combo that can make not only Territory of the Sharks a viable skill, but also can make number 32 Shark Drake a deadly monster in this meta. So I'm going to be talking about this deck, but also I'm going to be talking specifically about the use of Cosmic Cyclone versus the use of Forbidden Lance. Now, we're already kind of went over this. We already kind of talked about this. You know that the top cards in Duel Links right now, the most popular cards in Duel Links right now, are back row cards. You know that the most popular cards in Duel Links right now are all trap cards as well. You know, as you're taking a look here at the popularity rankings, you can see the first six cards are back row related, and the first six cards have the two biggest back row removals or back row counters, which is Forbidden Lance and Cosmic Cyclone. And then as you can see outside of that, the rest of the top six cards is the actual back row that you're trying to protect against, which is Floodgate Trap Hole, Karma Cut, Fiendish Chain, and Ballista Squad. Now, there is nothing wrong with these cards. These are all amazing, powerful cards, regardless of what you think about free to play, pay to win, people quote unquote cheating because they're using the best cards. That's not cheating. Cheating is when you actually, you know, use some type of device or some type of APK or some kind of, I don't know, process to subvert the normal processes of the game. If you do that, then that's cheating. But using the best cards isn't cheating. Using the best cards is just what it is, using the best cards. But as a rogue duelist, you cannot sit back and complain. You can't sit back and complain that, man, these cards are broken. You must find new ways to push the limits of your opponent and find new ways to subvert these cards. Now, the main way that people have used, the mainstream way to subvert these cards, are Forbidden Lance and also Cosmic Cyclone. But as you've known in the previous video that I've shown you, I use the Atlantean Marksman to remove the back row as I was activating effects, because the Atlantean Marksman operates in two capacities. Number one, he will destroy a back row. Number two, if the back row isn't the correct back row for the monster that was summoned, you know, let's say you were summoning Mermil Abyssius, if you were summoning this card, and let's say you just targeted one back row, you targeted their Cosmic Cyclone, and then they had nothing to chain it to, but they also had a Floodgate. Marksman has caused your opponent to blow two back row. You now have taken the advantage of getting rid of two back row, and now you can continue your play for whatever it was that you were doing, because this was a special summon and this was a cost to summon. So it's a different way of approaching the back row, which gives your deck the advantage, because you build your deck around taking advantage of a situation like that. But if your deck can't do something like that, you are heavily relying on the two cards, Cosmic Cyclone and also Forbidden Lance. Now, Cosmic Cyclone is a great card. You know, it's a cost 1,000 life points, And basically, after you pay that 1,000 life points, it's gonna get a card off the field, and not only get off the field, it's gonna banish it. Cosmic Cyclone is really great in any kind of deck that's gonna cost life points, any kind of deck that's going to benefit, or skill that's gonna benefit using Cosmic Cyclone. But the drawbacks for Cosmic Cyclone is it's a terrible top deck. The drawback for Cosmic Cyclone is that if you don't necessarily have it in your opening hand, it's pretty much useless unless your opponent is running some kind of continuous floodgate. Now, Cosmic Cyclone does get cards like Floodgate, Karma Cut, Ballista Squad, and Fiendish Chain out of here, but it's great for getting rid of field spells as well. And that's also another thing that you would want to have something like Cosmic Cyclone for. Now, I would say Cosmic Cyclone is great because it's more generic, but Forbidden Lance, on the other hand, this spell, I believe, is more tactical when you're using a combo deck. Basically, this card is going to allow you to continue a play. Rather than using a Cosmic Cyclone as your play begins, you would hold your Forbidden Lance in your hand and use it in response to someone's back row, you know, especially Floodgate, which is typically what I see a lot. You know, you summon, they do Floodgate, you do Lance. It seems like that seems to be the only reason I use Lance. I'm never lucky enough to have Lance on Fiendish Chain. You know, I always get Fiendish Chained, but I always have Lance for Floodgate. So, you know, in my personal opinion, I definitely think that, you know, Lance is the better card for this particular meta, because right now we're facing a lot of this Shiranui stuff, and Shiranui focuses heavily on just using back row like Ballista Squad, Floodgate. But if we were running against something, you know, like Dark Magician, Cosmic Cyclone would be the better card. And Dark Magician is a very powerful and popular deck, so Cosmic Cyclone is definitely a good deal against Dark Magician. But I don't like lowering my life points against a deck like Dark Magician, because they can get that 3,000 in real quick. And then also, I like Forbidden Lance, because even though they get to do the Dark Magician and get to do their search and they get to do everything, typically my OTK works better if they use their navigation to summon their Dark Magician first. And that's what you would call a bait. You're baiting your opponent to activate their Magician's navigation first to summon Dark Magicians to the field so that you can continue your combo and have an effect on the Dark Magicians. So that leads us into these conversations about Shark Drake. That leads us into the conversation about using different tactics to subvert the meta. Now, as you're going to see kind of moving forward here, number 32 Shark Drake is really good with combination of Atlantean cards and also the Sea Serpent engine. I was trying to play fish and I barely got any victories. Using the Sea Serpent engine, I can get somewhere between a 70% and 60% win rate. That's not the best win rate, but it's definitely strong and consistent enough to let me know that there is room for improvement. So the debate for this deck really is, what should you use, Cosmic Cyclone or Forbidden Lance, or should you lean more heavily into the Atlantean Sea Serpent combo? Personally, I think a spell card like Hey Trunade would definitely be helpful in this deck, or helpful in this meta in general. However, I don't think that this card is effective against the main deck that's out there, Shiranui. They have a continuous trap card that basically can allow them to banish cards at will. And in this deck, you don't want that option. Your opponent's back row is the most dangerous thing in Shiranui, and this card's Sealing Ceremony of Katun is absolutely disgusting against this deck, because we're using cards like Fishborg Planter to special summon from the graveyard, Dragonite and things like that. And then also your number 37 Hope Woven Dragon Spider, if this card dies, you can get a card back from the graveyard, and this card counters it directly. And not only counters it directly, gives the opponent the ability to destroy a card with the Shiranui monster that when it's banished, it can target and destroy a monster. So what is the true option here? The true option is, if you're going to be playing some kind of OTK, I think the best way to subvert your opponent's back row is to think of different clever ways to attack their back row that plays into your combo or plays against their combos. And one of the tech that I added was Lost Blue Breaker. You have to make sure that when you're trying to innovate and play against the metagame, that you are focusing heavily on rogue strategies that are outside the norm. Lost Blue Breaker is great in this deck because we can use Deep Sea Diva to summon, to special summon Lost Blue Breaker and tribute Lost Blue Breaker to destroy a card. Now, if we destroy Catan, they will get a banish, but then they did not get the banish of our Dragonite. They did not get the banish of our Fishborg because it's still in our hand, and this Lost Blue Breaker was our first move. So when we use White Stingray or Atlantean Abyssius to discard Fishborg Planter into the graveyard, then we can successfully use its effect, and now we have three monsters on the field. Pop territory at the sharks, all level fours, exceeds into Shark Drake and attack for game. Now, what makes all this possible? What's insane about this deck is this one card right here. Perform a Pal Swordfish. This card is the only reason Shark Drake is viable. You play Perform a Pal Swordfish, you complete your special summon by discarding your Fishborg Planter and special summoning White Stingray, and then using Fishborg Planter's effect to send a card off top of the deck to special summon. Right there, you've activated this effect three times. You have cut your opponent's attack points by 1800. If you've dropped your opponent's attack points by 1800, you should be able to deal 2000 damage with the first hit of Shark Drake. And when Shark Drake uses effect to bring the monster back, if you can successfully deal another 2,000 by cutting their monster's attack by 1,000, then you will win the duel. So this is what I mean by figuring out an alternative strategy to subvert the meta so that we can actually, as rogue duelists, push and defeat the Shiranui and not let them have such an easy time clapping in the KC Cup. It can get you some gems, gonna get you paid, and you're gonna make your boy proud. So get in there, my boys. Get in there and look into your cards. You don't have to necessarily use this deck, but you can use any deck to subvert the meta with your skill and your power as a true duelist. So enjoy these satisfying metagame clapping duels where we are gonna take some amazing victories with number 32 Shark Drakes and take a big scoop of glory. I'm gonna catch y'all in stage 2. And as always, keep it dank.